Days after police ticketed a sheriff's lieutenant for disorderly conduct at a West Allis strip club, licensing officials will now investigate to see if the club's owners should be sanctioned. New at 6, 12 News' Colleen Henry joins us from 95th and National. And Colleen, this isn't the first time the Crazy Horse Tavern has made headlines.
No, Terry, last month, Crazy Horse was the scene of a fight involving a prominent member of the Milwaukee County Sheriff's Department. But last year, it was the scene of alleged sexual assault. And that's got some in this neighborhood calling for sanctions against the club.
Its website boasts it's the hottest gentleman's club in the country. Now police are referring Crazy Horse to West Allis licensing regulators for review.
Hey, welcome to clubcrazyhorse.com. Look around. There's lots more of me to see.
Neighbors declined to talk on camera, but told 12 News they're tired of the disorderly and lewd conduct of the Crazy Horse patrons, and they'd love to see it shut down. Doors were locked when 12 News visited, but surveillance cameras captured the latest incident, this fight between a sheriff's lieutenant and another club guest, where tables were turned over and glasses broken. Police records indicate club management never called police and was reluctant to turn over the video. Last year, police executed a search warrant alleging the club's owner gave alcohol to underage women and, after hours here at the club, sexually assaulted one of them in the club's VIP champagne room. Just last month, prosecutors announced they would not file criminal charges against the owner, but a civil suit is pending. No one answered at the owner's home this afternoon, even though a car was running in his garage.
Crazy Horse really hasn't been a big problem. There's a lot more smaller bars that are way more problems than Crazy Horse has been.
West Allis Alderman Michael Chopleski heads the licensing committee that will review the incidents at Crazy Horse and says in cases where sanctions are necessary, they're gradual.
Now, the licensing committee generally gets incident reports once police wrap up their investigation, which means that committee could be looking at both incidents in the coming months. At 95th and National, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News.